Hello.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
Hello, good evening. How are you doing today?
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. How are you today?
I'm okay, teacher.
Great, awesome. It is raining. It's raining cats and dogs here. And I had a power outage. I couldn't finish the previous meeting and it's a disaster. And I am connected from my device, my cell phone, because I have no internet yet at home. So let's see how it goes. Okay, so how are you doing today? Is it raining there where you live?
Right now, no, teacher.
No, not right now?
No.
Okay, here, yes, it's raining. So I do apologize for the delay, but so those are things that we cannot control.
Oh my God. Yo no podía entrar, teacher, hasta ahorita, por eso llegué tarde.
Yes, I know. It because I couldn't finish the previous meeting. No pude terminar la clase previa porque en eso a pasar lista iba y cuando se fue un bajón de luz y el internet ya no quiere entrar. Entonces la otra meeting quedó corriendo y a todo esto yo estaba peleando por conectarme desde el celular a la computadora del internet.
Sí, ha estado dando ese problema porque he recibido clases en la tarde y nos ha sacado. O sea, sí, que no es como el internet, porque el Zoom nos ha sacado y como 4 veces quizás.
Sí, a lo mejor también eso está afectando, pero bueno, estamos aquí, ya entraron varios. So, well, let's begin. All those days that I wouldn't like to repeat. It's stressful. I sent the presentation before the class, so we are going to start today with section number 3. Please try to complete the exercise in the platform, because you must do that from section 1, 2, 3 and the midterm exam. If you need assistance, please ask us to assist you. We will be more than glad to help you. Okay, so I think I'm not sharing my screen, ma'am. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, so today's topic is gonna be this. How can I close that? Okay. What's your neighborhood like? That is the topic of section number 3. What is your neighborhood like? So, in this topic, we're going to be talking about our neighborhood existence or non-existence of things, right? That's weird. Some people is still trying, but the other meeting has ended. What's your neighborhood like? What do we need to do with this question? What are we asking for?
¿Cómo es tu vecindario?
Yes.
Yes, we are asking to describe the place where you live. So let's see, Rosa, what's your neighborhood like?
What's your name? Dígamelo en español para ver si me ubico. ¿Y le puedo contestar en inglés?
Yes, what is your neighborhood like? Estamos pidiéndole una descripción de su lugar donde vive, de su vecindario.
Okay. My... For example, My municipality is long, it's beautiful. Quiero decir, si quiero decir tiene personas maravillosas, sería people beautiful, ¿no?
It's beautiful people, the people is beautiful. Yes,
beautiful,
you can use that.
People, the hospital, in the supermarket, in this park, in very, very dogs. Tiene muchos perros también. Hay muchos perros aquí.
Oh, right, a lot of dogs.
Very dogs.
Oh, many people have pet dogs.
In the street.
All right.
Dogs, cats in the street. I breed cats.
A lot of cats. Okay.
Tree. Sí. Very tree. Muchos árboles.
Porque many trees. Tree. Many trees. 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 So you say yes. Trees. Many trees because three many is trees. The number.
Correct.
Very good. Now, Rosa, ask another classmate. What's your neighborhood like?
Sigue conmigo. No,
yes, you can ask another classmate. Pregúntele a otro compañero. Okay, what's your neighborhood like?
Okay. Ana Trinidad. Sería la pregunta que usted me hizo a mí.
What's your neighborhood like?
What?
Your neighborhood?
What's your neighborhood like?
Like, exactly. Ana Trinidad.
Ana Trinidad,
what's your neighborhood like?
I love you, Ana Trinidad.
My neighborhood like...
My neighborhood is...
Is very short.
Okay, it's very short, very small.
Very small. Is good. Ay, se me olvidó. el ambiente.
The environment. Environment.
Environment.
Environment.
Good environment.
Good environment. I don't know.
Okay.
My house is very, very small.
All right. Very good. Now you can ask another classmate.
Walter.
Okay.
What's your neighborhood like?
My neighborhood is calm, is colorful, is memorable. There is no thief in my neighborhood. My neighborhood is private. Only that, teacher.
Very good, excellent. Yeah. Now you can ask another classmate.
Okay, Emma, what's your neighborhood like?
My neighborhood is
Good evening, teacher.
Okay, so now, what do we need in order to describe? We need vocabulary, right? So that's why I included more vocabulary for you in the presentation. Les incluí un poco más de vocabulario en la presentación que nos ayuda a describir lugares. But we're going to start first with the conversation. I'm your new neighbor. Okay, as you can see in the first image, it says neighborhood. Whenever we talk about neighborhood, es el lugar. But neighbor is the person. Okay, neighborhood, refers to the place. Neighbor is the person.
El vecino.
Mm-hmm, exactly. Neighbor, vecino. Neighborhood es el lugar, el vecindario. Mm-hmm. So, we have the conversation. I'm your new neighbor. Okay, I'm your new neighbor. ¿Sí pueden ver la conversación, verdad?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher. Yeah.
Okay, yes. I will need a volunteer too, because no me voy a meter a la plataforma porque no sé si mi pobre internet de mi celular vaya a aguantar. Está funcionando bien, but I don't want to take that risk. It's too stressed for today, too much stress. Volunteer to practice with me?
Me, teacher.
Okay, Reina. Reina, you can start. I'm the old lady.
Okay.
You can start.
Excuse me.
Go ahead.
Excuse me.
On the press.
I am your new neighbor. Neighbor Jack, I just moved in. Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
Okay. I'm looking for a grocery store. Are there any around here? Around here?
Yes, there are some on Pine Street.
Oh, good. And is there a laundromat near here?
Well, I think there is one across from the shopping center.
Thank you.
By the way, there is a barber shop in the shopping center too.
A barber shop?
Thank you so much.
Excelente. Está bien interesante porque como ella lo ve peludo, lo está mandando para la barbería.
Está peludito, so, le dicen.
Puede. Dice, también hay una barbería ahí.
Sí, aprovechando, ¿verdad? Que va por ahí, puede ir a dejar la greña. Ok, so, questions about vocabulary, pronunciation.
What does mean laundromat?
A laundromat es una lavandería. Es más común decir laundry.
Laundry service. Laundry service.
Mm-hmm. The laundry is more common than laundromat, but it's the same thing. Mm-hmm. Okay, any other question?
Me, teacher.
Uh-huh.
Yo, a mí no me queda muy claro cuando ocupa are there or is there, porque para mí la grocery store no se puede no me queda claro cuando lo ocupa, si es plural o singular, o puede contar o no lo contar, pero no lo entiendo muy bien.
Oh, muy bien, Aida, gracias por brindar esto a nuestra atención. El is there lo vamos a usar cuando ambos es para hablar sobre la existencia o no existencia de algo, ¿verdad? Como decir, hay de haber, ¿hay algún banco cerca de aquí? Entonces, si vamos a preguntar por algo en singular, usamos is. Is there a bank near here? Pero si voy a preguntar en plural, uso are there. Quiero saber si hay... Ahí necesito yo ir a almacén, a tiendas de departamento como Simán, Prisma. Entonces quiero saber si hay department stores. But I'm going to ask in plural, are there any department stores near here? Mm-hmm. So si vamos a preguntar en plural, usamos are there. Y si es singular, usamos is there.
Okay,
y luego con el sol ni el Emi lo vamos a ver un poquito más adelante, siempre en esta sección.
There is, se puede contractar y there are no, ¿verdad, teacher?
There is.
¿Sí?
Sí, there's. Yeah. There are no. Uh-huh. Okay. Any other question?
Teacher.
Yes.
What do you mean by the way?
By the way, es por cierto.
Ah, okay.
Mm-hmm.
By the way.
By the way, por cierto.
Mm-hmm. By the way. I'm still on the way.
By the way. Mm-hmm. By the way.
Okay, let's repeat, everybody. Let's repeat.
By the way.
Excuse me, I'm your new neighbor, Jack. I just moved in.
Excuse me, I'm your new neighbor, Jack. I just moved in.
I just moved in.
Oh, yes. I'm looking for a grocery store. Are there any around here? Yes, there are some on Pine Street. Oh, good. And is there a laundromat here? Remember, it's near here.
Near here.
Well, I think there is one across from the shopping center.
Well, I think there's one across from the shopping center.
Thank you. By the way, there's a barber shop in the shopping center.
By the way, there's a barber shop in the shopping center.
Barber shop. Okay, I'll give you the chance to practice this conversation in the small groups. And thank you, because I see that most of you are here. Congratulations. I'm going to share, you have this presentation. Ya se las compartí. I already shared it. You have it in your WhatsApp. So I'm going to create the breakout rooms so you can practice more this conversation in groups with your classmates.
Let's go. Okay.
Okay, is everybody back?
Teacher, tengo una pregunta.
Yes.
Por ejemplo, cuando dice laundromat near here, ¿qué se refiere el near?
The meaning of the word near.
Ajá, near.
What is the meaning
cerca?
Of near?
Cerca.
Near cerca.
That's it. Cerca. Mm-hmm.
Cerca de aquí.
Cerca de aquí, sí. Yes. Near here.
¿Hay alguna
la palabra? The word near. Ajá. Eso sería. Is there any other question?
No.
No? Okay, so let me share my screen again. Because we're going to check the vocabulary that we have here. Okay, so in this case, we were practicing with the conversation. First, we started asking what's your neighborhood like, and we need, in order to describe, it would be great to include more vocabulary. So that's why I included this presentation with this slide. All right, so adjective to describe places. Let us repeat. Alive.
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 Amazing.
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 Beautiful.
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 Bright.
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 Calm.
Calm.
Colorful.
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 Creepy.
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 Crowded.
Crowded.
Deserted.
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 Different.
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 Dry.
Dry.
Enchanted.
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 Fresh.
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 Hot.
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 Incredible.
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 Interesting.
Interesting.
Magnificent.
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 Modern.
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 Excellent. Estaba atenta a ver si no pronunciaban la N, pero sí lo hicieron. Yeah, because it's very common that they say modern. The modern is
mama.
Modern. Mama. Yeah, so you need to pronounce it modern.
Modern.
Good job.
Modern.
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 Fairy tale like.
To like.
Mystical.
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 Ancient.
Ancient.
Majestic.
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 Impressive.
Impressive.
Spacious.
Spacious.
Dazzling.
Dazzling.
Evocative.
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 No questions, new vocabulary?
Yes, a lot.
Sure.
Alive, alive es un lugar como vivo.
Vivo.
Vivo. Vivo. Mm-hmm.
Teacher, y fairly tall, fairly tall like, como un cuento de hadas.
Fairly like es como un cuento de hadas, un lugar okay. Tan soñado como de un cuento de hadas, right?
No. Mystical quiere decir místico.
Yes.
Ok, mm-hmm. Místico.
Crowded.
Ancient.
Crowded is the crowded is when there is a lot of people. Many people.
Population.
Yes, for example, if you go to La Costa del Sol in the Holy Week, it's crowded.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Pizza Hut on Mother's Day. Crowded.
Creep.
Dazzling.
What is dazzling?
Es deslumbrante, teacher.
Yes, deslumbrante, dazzling. Mm-hmm.
Evocative es como memorable.
Es como evocador, algo que le invita a ir, ¿verdad? Le llama.
Ah,
mm-hmm.
Ah, okay.
Ancient.
Es un lugar como no viejo, pero
antiguo.
Sí, antiguo, similar. Uh-huh.
Y majestic, el cine.
Es un majestuoso.
El ex cine.
Uh-huh. Es un lugar majestuoso. Creepy es un lugar escalofriante que da miedo.
Uh-huh. Espeluznante.
Jeepers.
Ajá. Creepy. O sea, so those adjectives creepy. You can use them. Se pueden utilizar para describir lugares. Pero también pueden describir cosas con estos adjectives. For example, you can say, if you're going to describe a place using creepy, I can say La Mansión de los Girola is a creepy place, right? And they are making it a restaurant.
Yeah.
Creepy, I wouldn't go there.
Creepy and mysterious. Creepy and mysterious.
Yes, it's creepy, it's mysterious. And you can use some other adjectives to describe it.
You understand me?
Oh, the parties, Halloween parties in United States are creepy.
Excellent. Ajá, entonces está describiendo las fiestas. Uh-huh. Yes, so you can use them to describe different things, right? Pero son bastante usados también para describir lugares, ¿verdad? Y también pueden describir otras cosas, como el ejemplo que nos dio Walter.
Y dry es seco.
Es seco. Uh-huh. Un lugar seco, un lugar árido, seco.
Uh-huh.
Okay, and here we have some other adjectives. Let us repeat. Beautiful.
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 Clean.
Interesting. Crowded.
Bored.
Bored.
Exciting.
Exciting.
Polluted.
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 Big.
Big.
Safe.
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 Okay, questions?
Polluted is contaminante.
Contaminado, ajá.
Okay.
Contaminado. Like, you go downtown and the air is polluted.
Okay.
Yes. Or there is pollution. When you say pollution, it's contaminación. Uh-huh. Okay, so we can use those adjectives. I'm going to ask you to read the four paragraphs. And decide which adjective, you have to read the whole thing in order to decide which adjectives suits better in each paragraph. You can number the paragraph, say paragraph 1, 2, 3, 4, and write the adjectives that you think that suits better.
Beautiful in the one.
Mm-hmm. So you can write your answers in the notebook, and then we're going to check.
Oh my God. Okay.
Exciting.
It's a work of art. It is magical. It's scenery. It's a very... Orlando is a very interesting. It's amazing. One can never be. Never be bored. No, no. Debbie. City. And it's a very, very. Then garden is a tiny city in Switzerland. It is very children can walk along, it's very safe. And it is also very, they can swim in a
Have you finished?
Not yet, teacher.
Not yet.
Safe. Clean.
Okay, let's listen a volunteer for the first paragraph.
Me.
Okay, Jose.
Okay, now I have just a question, is Venice?
Venice.
Ah, Venice, okay, sorry. Venice is the most polluted city in the world, and one of that can be truly described as unique. Each building is a work of art. It's a magical scenery. It's very interesting.
Okay, a very nice job. Very nice. I have heard that the water, well, the water from that is like the channel.
Would
it
will be beautiful, teacher. The first.
Would be beautiful too.
Okay.
Yes, si pusieran beautiful también, porque sí es una ciudad muy bonita, quizás la más bonita del mundo, pero también se dice que el agua de ese río, de famoso canal de Venecia, es la más contaminado del mundo.
De hecho, hay una ley que no les permite a los ciudadanos tocar el agua por lo contaminado que está. Lo multan si tocan el agua.
Ok, sí, por eso sí podían usar ambas, ¿verdad? Igual a...
¿Puedo leerlo de otra opción, con otra opción?
Yes, that's okay, Aida.
Venice is the most beautiful city in the world and one that can be truly described as unique. Its building is a work of art. It is magical scenery. It's very exciting.
Okay, excellent. That can be another option. Esa puede ser, como les digo, especialmente este primer párrafo se presta a ambas opciones, como lo hizo Josué, como lo hizo Aida, it's okay. Y puede haber un par más por ahí. Thank you so much, Aida and Josué. Volunteer for the second
me
one.
Teacher, me teacher, me teacher, me teacher.
Hi.
Escuché me. A Walter y escuché a quién.
I am.
Okay.
Ok, vamos primero con Walter y si Ana tiene algo diferente nos lo dice y luego si no, pues vamos al tercero, Ana.
Orlando is a very amazing city because there are many Disney parks. It's amazing. One can never be bored when visiting Orlando.
Okay, very good job. Do you have something different, Ana?
Orlando is a very exciting city because there are many Disney parks. It's amazing. One can never be bored when visiting Orlando.
Excellent. Thank you so much. She is exciting. Uh-huh. That's mm-hmm. the difference. And it's a very, very good option as well. Now, let's move to Mumbai. I volunteer to read about Mumbai.
Me, teacher.
Okay, thank you so much, Maria Eugenia, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Mumbai is a very crowded city. There live 18 million people, and Ghaziabad is very polluted. The air there is not healthy. There are too many traffic congestion and dust.
Excellent. Yes. Excellent job. Ahí sí no para dónde con las opciones, ¿verdad? Crowded. Ajá, Mumbai is very, very crowded city. And then it's polluted. Okay, thank you so much. And the last one, volunteer for the last one.
Sí, ¿puedes un
pedazo? Rain Garden.
Me, teacher.
Okay, thank you.
Berngarten is a tiny city in
Switzerland.
It is very safe. Children can walk along everywhere. And it is also very clean. They can swim in a big river.
Excellent. Yeah. Excellent. That's the answer here. You did a very, very nice job here. So, how was the exercise? ¿Qué les pareció el ejercicio?
Excellent, teacher.
Excellent, teacher. Thank you.
Excellent. Okay.
Very good.
I am happy because you practice, you learn new vocabulary. And as you see in the paragraph, you can write about other cities. Pueden agarrarlos de ejemplo para escribir ustedes un poco más y practicar. So let's move. I'm going to continue with the, well, we had the presentation about the reason there are ones on any, but I'm not going to play that video. I'm going to continue with this. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, this is the
yes, about sure.
There is, there are, one, any, and some. And basically, this is what you see in the video. We're going to be asking questions using there is, there are, one, any, and some. As I was telling at the beginning, is there, we use it for singular, okay? Vamos a usar is there cuando preguntemos sobre algo en singular. Y pues podemos usar el quantifier a or an, dependiendo de cómo suene la palabra que viene después. So we have the example here. Is there a laundromat near here? You answer using there is or there isn't. Yes, there is. There is one across from the shopping center. No, There isn't, but there is one next to the library. Right? If we are going to ask, so in plural, we use are there. Are there any grocery stores around here? We say, yes, there are. The answer is there are. Oh, no, there aren't. Let's see the example here. Yes, there are. There are some nice stores on Pine Street. No, there aren't, but there are some on Third Avenue. No, there aren't any around here. We have the prepositions. Let's read the prepositions on. Next to.
Next to.
Near.
Near.
Close to.
Close to. Close
to. Across from.
Across from.
Opposite.
Opposite.
In front of.
In front of.
From.
In back of.
In back of.
Back of.
In back of.
Behind.
Behind.
Between.
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 On the corner of.
The corner of.
Corner of.
Okay, questions. ¿Habían preguntas hasta acá?
Teacher, opposite, ¿qué significa?
Opposite y across from son como al otro lado de, o con, o
al contrario.
Uh-huh.
Okay, teacher.
Teacher, any and ningún.
We use any, yes, como decir ninguno.
Ninguno.
O, también se usa en preguntas. Ajá.
Okay.
Any other question? ¿Alguna otra pregunta con esto? Acuérdense que el one lo vamos a usar con singulares, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Any lo podemos usar en preguntas y en oraciones negativas. ¿Ok? Uh-huh. Si ustedes ven aquí, está el any. Are there any grocery stores around here? Y contestamos también negativo con any. No, there aren't any. Okay, around here. El some lo podemos ocupar en preguntas y también en respuestas afirmativas. Okay, la diferencia, como les explicaba en el módulo anterior, porque decimos que some y any, ambos se pueden usar en pregunta. Cuando estamos haciendo respuestas afirmativas, usamos some. Y para respuestas negativas usamos any. Ahí sí hacemos como una diferencia, ¿verdad? Si vamos a responder afirmativo, usamos some como quantifier, ¿verdad? Como para dar un algunos, como decir. Y si lo usamos en oración negativa, el any es como decir ninguno o nada de. Pero ambos se pueden usar en preguntas. En este caso, solo vamos a ver el any en preguntas porque cuando preguntamos con any, es como si no tenemos idea, right, de cuál puede ser la respuesta o no tenemos ni idea de la información que estamos pidiendo. Entonces usamos any.
I have a question, teacher.
Yes.
Yo no sé si lo vas a ver de la siguiente lámina o pero fíjese que a mí no me quedó claro porque yo ocupo, había una oración que decía, is there much public transportation near here? ¿Por qué ocupo is there much en lugar there is many? Y el complemento es public transportation. Se está en singular, pero ¿por qué ocupo there is much y no there is many?
Es porque el public transportation, la palabra public transportation es incontable. No tiene plural. Sí, sí, lo vamos a ver más adelante. Lo vamos a ver, mañana vamos a practicar esto. y también eso, lo que usted está mencionando. Mañana lo vamos a practicar y lo vamos a explicar más. Vamos a ampliar ese tema. Mañana terminamos esto. De hecho, sí se los incluí acá. Lo vamos a ver mañana, el many y el much. ¿Cuándo usar many? ¿Cuándo usar much?
Okay.
Sí, ahí está en la presentación. Lo vamos a cubrir mañana. Ahorita estamos acá. Y sí, vamos
many
a
es contable, punto. El much es incontable.
Ajá, much es incontable.
Many es
para contable. Palabras incontables, como public transportation, esa palabra no tiene plural, igual que crime. El noun crime es incontable, la palabra crime.
Correct.
No tiene plural en inglés, so it's incontable. Y ahí es donde vamos haciendo esa separación, ¿verdad? Cuando usar much y cuando menos.
Okay.
Good. Any other question?
Pasar lista, teacher.
Oh, yes.
Antes de que se le vaya.
Yeah.
Antes que se me vaya la luz, sí, porque entramos tarde, entonces sí. Déjenme ver. En el otro grupo me quedé, no pude pasar lista. Y se me borró lo que ya había hecho. Desastre. A ver qué me dicen. Bueno. Cosas que suceden.
Pero quedan grabados, teacher.
Fíjese que sí, la clase sí quedó grabado, pero no quedó completa. Entonces, cuando auditan eso, a veces tenemos problemas.
Sorry.
Sí, igual la lista no me guardó. Así que sí.
A todos póngales ok que estuvieran.
La mayoría, solo uno o dos faltaron.
Mañana se los confirma. ¿Quién no vino ayer?
Sí. Ay, Dios. Lo perdí el file. Ok. Aida María.
Present, teacher.
Alejandro Ernesto.
Present, teacher.
Alfredo Antonio. Alfredo Antonio.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Ana Trinidad.
Present.
Carlos Armando.
Present, teacher.
Claudia Stephanie.
Present, teacher.
Diego Edgardo.
Present, teacher.
Dinora Estela.
Present, teacher.
Diomedes Tito.
Present.
Edwin de Jesús.
Present, teacher.
Edwin Jaciel. Edwin Jaciel. Creo que no está. Miriam Yamile.
Present, teacher.
Emma Tatiana.
Present.
Fátima Verónica.
Present.
Glenda Yamile. ¿Dónde está? Irving Norberto.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Jacqueline Jennifer.
Present, teacher.
José Mauricio.
Present.
Catherine Abigail. María Catalina. María Catalina.
Present.
Ok, thank you. Ya decía yo si la vi por ahí. María Eugenia.
Present teacher.
Norma Evelyn.
Present teacher.
Ok, Liden Jesús.
Present teacher.
Oscar David.
Present teacher.
Osmel Antonio.
Here teacher.
Reina Carolina.
Present teacher.
Rosa Guadalupe.
Present teacher.
Saraí Beatriz.
Present.
Walter Rafael.
Present teacher.
Yasmine Stephanie. Yasmine Stephanie. Okay, I think she's not here. Okay, so let's see. I know someone has having issues with the exercise in the platform.
I have a problem, teacher.
Okay, what number of exercise was it? I'm asking because they are writing us, nos están escribiendo, y sí, chequeé ahora, ahora a mediodía, chequeé las notas, y hay muchos que solo han avanzado la sección 1. Para mañana debe de estar terminada la sección 1, 2, 3 y el midterm exam. Y sí, falta bastante de este grupo. Hasta mediodía que revisé, sí faltaban, porque sí me dijeron, mire de su grupo, por favor, quiero ver si es cierto. Y sí. ¿En qué ejercicio tiene problema?
3.11. 3.11. I don't understand the answer.
No, let me check. 3.11. Ah, it's the one that we are studying right now. Let's see. I see that some, como tres que ya terminaron todo. That's excellent.
Yeah,
yeah. Yes, I saw. Hay como
solo eso me hace falta, teacher, a mí.
At this part.
I'm happy, teacher.
Yes.
I'm happy, teacher.
No, no entiendo cuando selecciono las respuestas.
Ah, es que en esa, si una la tiene mala, le da malo todo el ejercicio.
Así es, correcto.
Pero identifico, identifico como cuatro en el último párrafo.
Todas están en el último párrafo. Mm-hmm. Bueno, me...
mm-hmm.
Okay, good school. What do you have? It says in the word in one neighborhood. The word in one neighborhood. Wow, it sounds interesting. So you read the exercise, and then the instruction says, check the things you can find in Soria.
Oh, yeah.
What can you find there? What did you check?
Inexpensive store, yes.
Uh-huh.
Many different cultures.
Uh-huh, what else?
Good school.
Good school?
No.
No.
Big apartment.
No.
A big apartment, yes.
Big apartment?
Yeah. A question, teacher, a question. Hay que leer detenidamente para poder poner la respuesta, porque si solo se va poniendo así como tipo copia, no se va a aprender. A mí mi hija me castigó. Agarra una página y póngase a leer párrafo por párrafo, porque si no lo ponen en el orden le va a salir malo. ¿Sí?
Inexpensive stores. What else?
Great market.
Many restaurants.
Great market.
Great
Great market.
Nice restaurant.
Nice restaurant. Good public transport.
Good public transportation. Yes.
Okay.
That is all.
No good school. No, it's this.
No.
That's it.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
It's correct. And the mm-hmm. tienen que tener chequeada solamente in expensive stores, big apartments, great markets, nice restaurants, many different cultures, and good public transportation.
Mm-hmm. Transportation.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Son tres las que no van a chequear porque no existen ahí de acuerdo con el párrafo.
Okay. Got it.
Y algo también, en el siguiente ejercicio que no me acuerdo quién fue que me ayudó, yo se lo agradezco, no hay que poner punto, porque si ustedes ponen punto al final de la oración, se los toma malo, aunque esté bueno.
Yes.
Se nos va a poner el punto final de la oración.
Es en el que sigue después de él.
Sí, sí.
Sí. Solo que no pongan punto.
Ok, good. Good advice. Thank you so much. ¿Hay algún otro ejercicio que quieran que revisemos? Esto ya lo revisó, ya vio cómo va
ya,
a ir.
Ya lo corregí, teacher.
Excelente. ¿Alguien más? ¿Hay algún otro ejercicio que les esté dando inconveniente?
No, teacher.
No, no, no. Ok, o no se recuerdan.
No, ya no hay, teacher.
Hay uno que sí me dio problema, pero lo logré detectar al final. No sé si en el intermedio, en el examen.
Ah, that is the exam. Este es el examen. So, en este ejercicio creo que es en el que les dice a Ida que no vayan a poner punto, ¿verdad?
No, en el siguiente.
En el cuarto. Jeff doesn't exercise very much. Ese me dio problema. Pero sí, al final lo logré yo corregir. Yo
creo ya que es en el middle exam test, el 4. Ese no tiene que llevar puntos porque si no lo toma malo.
Este.
Ah, yes, ese. A mí el último
sí, me dio problema. Este no tiene que llevar puntos.
No.
A la hora de escribirlo, solo escribir sin punto final.
Okay, yeah, I saw. Put the words in the correct order to make sentences or questions. In this is sentence. ¿Sí? What did you write?
I often watch TV.
After dinner. I often watch TV after dinner. No le ponga punto porque se lo toma malo.
Es que el punto lo tiene por defecto. Ya él. Al final.
Ok. In the number 2. It's question.
Sí.
It's a question, yes. Do you?
Do ever drink do you, coffee?
Do you ever?
Do you ever drink coffee?
Drink coffee in the afternoon? In the evening, sorry.
Did you place the question mark?
Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Jeff, and finally.
Jeff. Doesn't exercise.
Very much.
Very much, yes.
Sin punto.
Very much. Okay, so, para los que no han llegado ahí, acuérdense que este es el orden correcto y no vayan a poner puntos. Sí, es que yo vi que alguien estaba escribiendo y le dije, ¿están bien? Le dije.
A mí, era Ida, sí.
Yo y le contesté.
Sí, gracias.
Okay, so good. Y ya los que ya cuando lleguen allá, ustedes los que todavía no han pasado por ahí, pues ya no deberían de tener este problema. So thank you for sharing, Aida. Any other exercise that you would like to share? Any tip or algo que esté trabando la plataforma que ustedes se acuerden? No.
No, teacher.
Okay, so that would be it. Remember to work on
that.
Trabajen en eso porque sí, ya para esta semana están revisando y están bastante estrictos con esto. Hay que tener avanzado hasta el midterm exam, todo, para que pues ya están haciendo papeleos y reservando cupos para ver cómo va a estar el otro módulo. Así que, por favor, y cualquier cosa, pues ahí en el grupo nos asistimos, ¿ok?
Okay.
Thank you.
Perdón, la última, solo para corroborar, ¿hasta qué punto tenemos que tener terminado?
Hasta el midterm exam.
Toda la sección 3, incluyendo el midterm, todita. O sea que usted ya tiene que empezar.
Excelente.
Okay.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well done, sir. Thank you for joining and see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, teacher. Bye, everybody. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.